Hello students, I'm Tanmay. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry, the Mystery of Molecules. So this is a continuation lecture of the reaction which I have discussed in my previous videos. Two videos I have uploaded, basic concept and mechanism. And this is the extension of this reaction. Today we are going to discuss about two main reactions, that is Fittig reaction and Wurtz-Fittig reaction. Actually, these two reactions are the extension of Wurtz reaction. Okay. So in this video, what we are going to learn? We are going to learn the basic concept and the differences, mechanism of the reaction, support for the mechanism, and side products. Okay, so a lot of chemistry to be discussed in this video. Let's start. So before going to details, I need to give you a brief overview about the Wurtz reaction. Okay, so the Wurtz reaction is RX alkyl halide plus sodium. So what it resulted? It resulted the removal of this in terms of 2 sodium and resulted RR. Disadvantage of this method, unsymmetrical alkane not possible. You will end up with a mixture. And the difficulty was that the boiling point are close to the side product, so it is very difficult to separate them. I have discussed in the previous video, so I am not going to discuss. Fine. And so this is the Wurtz reaction, and how this reaction happens? This sodium produces sodium plus and electron, and that electron actually responsible to generate this two R dot plus X minus. This X minus combines with this sodium, and 2 R dot combines to give this R. Okay, so this is the very crude explanation. Now, let's discuss about the Fittig reaction. This is, you can say, the extension of Wurtz reaction, because this is, Wurtz reaction is for aliphatic. Now, if you see the aromatic counterpart of Wurtz reaction, that is the Fittig reaction. So, this is the aromatic counterpart. What if this means ARX? For example, let's give you an example. This is a chlorobenzene in presence of sodium. Similarly, this is also chlorobenzene. So, 2 sodium, the sodium chloride eliminates. This is a strategy to remember what will be the product, and this results in, this is called biphenyl or diphenyl, whatever you can say. So, this is a biphenyl. So, this is the Fittig reaction. Okay. So, in this case, what happens? This sodium similarly produces this sodium plus an electron. These electron given to this, and it ultimately result pH radical. And 2 pH radical, for example, this pH and this pH, this, keep it in mind, this is a fish hook arrow, half arrow, and resulted in the formation of this bond. So, why I have written this is a CC coupling reaction? Because see, two bonds are coupled together. This is a CC bond. This is produced. This is the Fittig reaction. Okay, aromatic. And what is the Wurtz-Fittig reaction? This is a combination of both 1 and 2. How it happens? So, Wurtz-Fittig. Is this, if you take an aromatic halide X, generally we don't take fluoride, so always remember fluoride not plus 2 sodium plus another X or X prime whatever aliphatic halide. So this is aliphatic and this is aromatic. Fine. So what happens? This leaves and ultimately resulted in R phenyl. So, this is the Wurtz-Fittig reaction. Now, interesting point is that in case of the Wurtz reaction, we told that unsymmetrical is not possible. Fine. And here we are observing this is actually unsymmetrical. So, this is the beauty of this. And what do I mean by unsymmetrical? Because if you break from this bond that is formed, these two parts are different. If you see this, this is also symmetrical. but this is unsymmetrical. So this is the basic background concept and difference between these two reactions. Now the question is why this is happen and how this is happen. So means the mechanism. So what happens here? Actually, in this case, sodium also played a role for the reducing agent. So, and generally sodium is alkali metal. So what happened? It is highly interested to give its electron to someone else, means who need it. So similar thing is happens. Here, sodium, what it does, it produces that electron. This sodium metal produces this sodium plus highly stable because of octet field plus electron, and this electron acting as a reducing agent. So what happens here? This electron, for example, this AR as well as XR. Now question, one question come, which will be reduced first? It depends on the bond strength of these, whatever. This is also a carbon halogen bond, this is also a carbon halogen bond. This carbon halogen bond's bond strength, is it visible?
Yes, it is visible.
So depending on the bond strength of this bond. Okay, so keep it in mind, we can't say that okay, this AR will break or this aliphatic will break, aromatic. We can't say, it depends on the substrate. So it is better, generally for your exam, you can avoid this. But for understanding, I have told. Now, the question comes, this is fine. Now, okay, if it is, then what happens? Let's consider two cases, means case A and case B, both separately. How this reaction happens? So for case A, what happens? Let's consider AR. It will be generalized. ARX plus electron. This electron is given to the sigma star orbital of this ARX. Consequently, the bond order decreases and ultimately this opens up to prepare AR radical plus X minus. How? So here this sigma bond, bonding orbital has two electrons. So bonding orbital. Initially antibonding minus ABO, 0 electron divided by 2. This is not bonding, this is bonding electron, this is antibonding electron. Fine, so bond order is here 1, means a single bond, this case. But when 1 electron is given, then what happens? Then BO, 1 electron equal to 2 minus 1 by 2. Equal to, it is 0.5. So bond is half broken after accepting electron. Second, what happens? If you see that this X is Cl, Br or iodide. In short, electronegative. Electronegative. So what happened? That when bond order is very low and it has an excess electron, then this X prefers to take the electron. That's why it's broken in this way. And if you think the reverse one, for argument, this is Ar minus plus X dot. Will it be stable? Because radical is a 7 electron species and electron deficient. But this, here, this is 7 electron, electronegative atom, not preferred. Similarly, Ar minus, we know carbon is not that much strong electronegative. That's why this will also not be preferred. Consequently, this pathway will not be preferred. So next, what happens? This again accept one another electron from another sodium. So actually I have shown two sodium. So this is the sodium first and now this is the second sodium. So what happens? This AR takes another electron, now produce AR minus and counter anion is sodium. By the way, you should keep in mind that not only sodium, like lithium, potassium, they can also perform, is capable to perform this job. But one thing, not only them, along with that iron, copper can also do, but we will not consider, based on my understanding, I will not consider this because they are transition metal, they are redox active. So we will not consider. So if you want to think what are the other reducing metal is better to use, that is lithium and potassium, you can say. Fine. So this, now one confusion comes. Previously I told that Ir- minus is not stable, will not form, but now why this is for me here? Now here the question of relative reactivity. So previously this is more electron hungry, and electron if gets to this, it is stable. So for example, you have two people to eat and you have a food for 1.5 people. Then we will give, okay, the person who eat less and who is more hungry, give them some more food. In this way, both hunger is stabilized. Same thing is for this. Now, when excess food comes, then the person who have taken little less food, then it is the turn for that person to get food, and here is electron. So that's why this is now Ir minus. So what happens in the next step? In next step, there was a XR and this is aliphatic. Okay, so you may consider this is a SN2 type reaction, backside attack, and this opens. Just I am saying, but prefer not to say this word. Okay, because it is very confusing and it is difficult to prove. So this, it attacks here and it leaves and ultimately it produces ARX. Fine, so path number 1. Now let's discuss about the path number 2. Path number 2 means, in this case, first the aliphatic one will react. What do I mean? So this RX plus sodium. So similarly, like Wurtz reaction, first it produces this R dot, X minus is there, so it will not react. This R dot can take another electron similarly to R minus and then react. But this is one way, but based on my understanding, this is more logical compared to this, because this R minus is going to attack on this. So we know that this is the sp2 system, so here this type of attack is not favored. For that reason, another mechanism is suggested, and which explain both of the factors. So what is that mechanism? That mechanism is actually a radical coupling mechanism. Okay, so what do I mean? So this AR dot here produced, and in this case this R dot produced, in both cases. So first, now I told that which bond is weaker, that will be broken first. Let's accept that ARX is weaker. So this will break first, fine. Second it will break. Or if this is weaker, first it will break, then it will break. Means both radical, this AR radical plus this R radical, they both combine and ultimately result this ARR. So this is, so actually here this all are possible. Means, and since I am telling this all are possible, then there is a confusion. What is the proof? Means if I say this many possible, then question comes, what is the proof? Proof is that, so during the reaction, if you purge, means it is observed that in RX this case, if you, in this reaction medium, if you purge carbon dioxide, it results carboxylic acid. Okay, so if carbon dioxide is electron deficient, how it will react, result in carboxylic acid? Only if this R minus is produced. So this R minus will attack, it will open, and second step work up, resulting carboxylic acid. But you can say in the reaction medium, there are sodium and electron. So if you react electron with carbon dioxide, what is expected? So electron will attack here, it will open. So ultimately results in formic acid. HC00, one double bond is intact, another OH. But we are not getting formic acid, we are getting carboxylic acid. This means that this nucleophile, means this carbon ion, which is acting as a nucleophile, is produced during the process. Okay? So this is another proof. Now, another proof. So I have given the proof for the carbon ion pathway. Now let's give the proof for radical pathway. Actually, you told that this AR radical is producing. It is observe that is in chlorobenzene, if it reacted under this condition, it produces this radical. Fine? This sp2 radical, what happens? It ultimately, one minor product is observed, that is, let me check.
Okay,
so it results in tryptycine. It made mistake. Tryptycine you can consider in this way, that this one benzene is attached to three benzene. This. So how this is possible? You can write the canonical form in this way, then you can prove that this all acts as a computer. This is a tryptycine. Okay, so how this happens? So if this is, and there is an another similar type of reagent, similar type of benzene nucleus, so aromatic, through aromatic electrophilic substitution, this can produce. So these two supports that the mechanism actually follows both path. Means both path means this radical path as well as carbon ion. Means organosodium you can say produced, or directly this radical is produced. Okay. So this basic mechanism, this thing we have discussed. Now another important thing is that since it's a cross coupling, you can say, means CC coupling, that's fine, but actually between the two different substrates, unsymmetrical coupling. So expected that there will be side product, because during the discussion of Wurtz reaction, we told that if you take unsymmetrical substrate, there is a chance that the preparation of side product, and that is a biggest problem. That's why you can prepare unsymmetrical substrate through Wurtz reaction. But we can prepare using this reaction. Why? Because the unique reactivity and reaction pattern, fine. But if we say this also, then there is a chance of side product. And what type of side product? Side product by self-coupling. What do I mean? For example, let's consider this Rx. So, like Wurtz reaction, we know this 2Rx plus 2Na, what it may result? RR plus 2NaX. Fine. One side reaction. Similar side reaction, this is Wurtz reaction. Wurtz reaction. And another side reaction is Fittig reaction. Fittig reaction means this ARX, two molecule plus two sodium, what ultimately result? This biphenyl plus two NX. Now, you have to think one thing. Since there is a chance that it will result in the formation of mixture, but still, why? Why we are considering this is a good method? Because based on this same logic, we have rejected Wurtz reaction for the preparation of unsymmetrical. Or you can say the even number. You can say the even number also is a good word, I believe, even. Not odd number you can prepare. So why this is? This is because of the main reason was, in the Wurtz reaction, the reason was close boiling point. Boiling point of product, main product, it is better to say, versus side products. Okay? So this is the main product versus side product. Close boiling point. Why? For example, if you take ethyl bromide and you are coupling to, if you take methyl bromide plus ethyl bromide, you are doing coupling. So chances 3. So one is this methyl to ethyl, plus is ethyl to ethyl, and the another thing is methyl plus methyl. So means this is ethane, this is propane, 3 carbon, means it is a C2 hydrocarbon, it's a C3, it's a C4, so boiling point is not that much different. But if you think similar way, for this example, see, if these are, for example, this is methyl iodide, methyl bromide, then this is a methyl, means it's a ethane, C2, means let's write it, ethane. If you consider here, this is, then it should be this, this is toluene, fine, and this is biphenyl, and in reality, this is a gas, this is a liquid, and this is a solid, this biphenyl is solid. So now you can see, there is a huge difference in the boiling point of these products.
So, and this huge difference is the advantage. Advantage for?
Advantage for separation of them. What do I mean? Actually, this is minor product. Minor product. This is also minor product. So, both are minor product. But this is major product. Major product. So, this could be separated very easily. Okay? So, this. And another important point which I forget to mention, for all these case, we need dry ether. Same. Let's light it DE. So, this is, or this is also dry ether. Why? Because if the ether contains moisture, so what happened? Moisture means water, and it will react with sodium, and ultimately may result sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen. So, this is one chance that in this way, the reagent will be wasted. Find this, so metallic sodium, which is a reagent for us, will be wasted. Second, so you can see that, okay, let's think that we will take excess sodium, because if you see the ether dehydration method, that is also done using sodium. So we will not do two step, we will do one step, then what problem? It will be there in the reaction medium, we will add extra, but that has another problem. Because you are using sodium hydroxide, means it contains this hydroxyl minus, it can act as an alkali, and you have RX. So, this hydroxyl minus can give another side product, it can add this substitution or elimination. So, what could be possible side reaction in this case? Substitution reaction or elimination, depending on the number of carbon chain, both possible. Fine. Second, if the condition is so much drastic, then we know that under very drastic condition, these halobenzenes reacts to produce benzyne, means this, and from that they can produce phenol. But I shall say not phenol, actually phenoxide. Phenoxide, and we should say sodium, so after water workup it may result phenol. But I would rather say chances of this reaction is very less, because preparation of benzyne is very difficult, and this process also needs, this is also actually Dow process, this process is also difficult because it needs drastic condition. In this context, I want to mention that I have already uploaded a video about this Dow process, where you have an understanding about the completeness of this process, that how much difficult this process is and how much drastic condition is essential to carry out this reaction. Fine. So this, but when we are doing any reaction, we always prefer to take maximum precaution such that side product number or amount is minimum and maximum is our target product. So this one. So that is the basic thing. So this is the complete understanding or discussion about this Wurtz-Fittig reaction. So another point you remember, all these reactions are carried out in presence of a very means reactive reagent, that is sodium, and electron is the strongest reducing agent in the chemistry. So this is the strongest. So the functional group tolerance, means the sensitivity for other functional group, is also higher for this case. So you have to keep this factor in mind, and this is the reason which limits the wide application of this methodology. Okay, so this is the overall discussion of this process, and this is the end of this discussion. Thank you everyone for having patience to listen to this video. So if you think this video is deserving, please share it among your friends so that many people could be benefited, and I shall also be very happy to observe that many people is getting benefited from my effort. So thank you everyone. See you in my next video.